Hey everyone, I am Udayraj. As a designer, you will need to optimize designs for various devices like desktops, mobile, and even smartwatches. In this video, we will learn how to create responsive designs like this using constraints, layout grid, and auto layout. Timestamps are added in the description so that you can skip or repeat specific topics without a hassle. Let's get started. In Figma, any layer or child frame can be constrained to the edges of the parent frame. Once constrained, the child frame will maintain its position from the edges. These constraints are visible as dashed lines. You can set constraints on horizontal axes such as left, right, both left and right, center, and scale. Let's see a quick demo. By default, all layers are constrained to top and left edges. I am applying left, center and right constraints respectively. Just resize the frame to see it in action. On vertical axis, they are top and bottom, center and scale. Now let's apply vertical constraints to these layers and observe how they behave on resize. Now we can try center constraints. Select all layers and change the default constraints to center. Resize the frame to check the behavior. Left and right, top and bottom, and scale are a little tricky to understand. That's why I'll give you a quick demo. Here are two identical squares inside a frame. Every dimension and spacing is 100 pixels for easy calculations. I am setting constraints as left and right for square 1 and scale for second. Now let's double the width of these frames using simple math. Both squares now have increased width. First square is maintaining the same distance from left and right edge just like the original one. Whereas second square has enlarged in equal proportions as frame. It has doubled its width just like frame without maintaining distance from the edges. I hope the difference between left and right versus scale is now clear. Using frame constraints alone is not enough. We have to use grids to create responsive designs. In Figma, not only parent frame but also child frames are capable of using grids. The fantastic thing is, if you have a layer placed on a grid, constraints will respect grid's boundaries instead of frames. Let's understand this behavior by adding 3-column grid to these tabs. First, add the layout grid to tab. This works only when the column type is selected as stretch. Assign left constraints to all the icons. Resize the frame and observe that all icons move with the left edge of the grid instead of frames. If you use center constraints within a grid, you can create evenly spaced tabs which move with respect to the center of the grid. Pause the video here and try all the constraint properties before moving to the next part. Now you have got all the basics to create your first responsive design. Here are some components from my personal website. Currently, it's non-responsive design. Spend about a minute visualizing how all layers should behave at different sizes. Now we are ready to go. I will start by adding standard 12-column layout grid for web project. Let's start with the menu. The logo should stick to the left edge, links to the center, button and burger menu to the right. All elements should be vertically centered. Make sure that the outer frame is set to scale horizontally. Otherwise, it won't work. Once all the constraints are applied, resize the frame to test. It looks perfect. Now let's deal with the image. I want image to scale, but I also want it to respect right margin. That's why I'll select left and right constraints. Check to see if it respects margin and layout grid. It's working as expected. The next step is to add constraints to the text block. I want everything left aligned and want to scale maintaining its left and right margins. Make sure that the text is set to auto height. Try resizing the frame. Everything is working fine except we now have uneven spacing in the text boxes. To help us fix this, Figma has an excellent feature called auto layout. Let's understand the basics of auto layout. As the name suggests, it automatically adjusts the height or width of the layout by maintaining the spacing and padding. To use this feature, select all the layers in the text block, click Auto Layout, or you can also use keyboard shortcut Shift plus A. As you can see, Figma automatically adds even spacing between the layers. Just like constraints, you have to choose their alignment from the top right. Use Stretch property, which is same as left and right constraint. We have to apply constraint to our auto layout frame too. We are good to go. Let's try resizing again. Now our text block maintains spacing between layers by adjusting the height. Let's add a final touch by adjusting vertical spacing. This looks perfect. We can optimize this design even for a smaller displays. Let's start by copying menu to a new artboard. Resize frame and hide links and buttons. Make burger menu icon visible. Next, I want image to show up first, so let's copy that to a mobile display. As you can see, Figma retains all the constraints and properties we applied. So optimizing for mobile displays is just a piece of cake. The last step is to copy a text box. For smaller displays, I will reduce the font size. Text block adapts nicely, thanks to auto layout. We have now successfully created a fully responsive website section. I'm sure that you can now use constraints, layout grids, and auto layout together to create beautiful responsive designs. Hit like if this video was helpful and consider subscribing to this channel to stay updated with the next tutorial on Figma. If you want to know more about specific topic or have feedback for me, let me know in the comments below. Thanks for watching it. See you in the next one.